Last week, the story broke of a newspaper editor, a man who obviously loved the left-wing media. He was a part of the left-wing media. And this man, Roy Greenslade, admitted in an interview that was published last week that he was pretty much a lifelong supporter of the Provisional IRA. And he wasn't a supporter of the IRA when they declared their ceasefires. That would have been bad enough, because even after they declared their ceasefires, they still were involved in a lot of extremely unpleasant activity, including bank robbery, murder, and many, many other crimes. But no, Mr. Greenslade admitted to supporting the IRA right the way through their murderous campaign, while they were killing Irish and British men, women, and children by the thousands, irrespective of uniform or religious creed. The bombs and the bullets of the IRA were indiscriminate. Of course, they were mainly focused at murdering British soldiers, British policemen, British politicians, unionists, loyalists, and Protestant farmers. But there were many, many Roman Catholics and even Irish Republicans who were killed by the murder gangs of the IRA. Some of whom were taken away by the notorious internal security unit of the IRA, which incidentally was being run by British intelligence. These individuals were taken away by men like Freddie Scappaticci, Brendan Davison, John Joe McGee. They were tortured. They were burned with cigarettes sometimes. They were subject to psychological and physical torture. They were brutalized. And they were cruelly taken away, many times thinking that they were actually going home. And they were shot in the back of the head, dumped on border roads with bin bags covering their bodies. And Mr. Greenslade thinks that this organization and his support for it was completely justified, thinks the activities of this organization were completely justified. And then he bleats on about how the fact that there was a security war going on, and there was an intelligence war going on that infiltrated these groups. He says that led him to support the Provisional IRA. Putting all that aside, I think there's a more fundamental question that the left-leaning press and the left-leaning media, which basically accounts for all of the media in Northern Ireland, have to answer. Not just in Northern Ireland, in the Republic of Ireland, in Scotland, in England, in fact, throughout these British Isles. And that question is this: how compromised are you? How infiltrated are you by extreme left-wing groups? I saw in Scotland, and I hope we've got the name right, because if I haven't, I could be in bother. But I think it was an ex-BBC correspondent. I think it was Angus Robertson, who was the BBC's Scotland correspondent. Is an SNP, I think an MLA, or certainly a very senior member of the Scottish National Party. And he was the man that was working for the BBC. Meant to be impartial. Well, he obviously wasn't that impartial, because you don't suddenly have a Road to Damascus conversion and go from not believing anything to believing radically that Scotland should be independent. Piers Morgan. I love talking about Piers Morgan. Piers Morgan, who has written his book about wokeness. He's probably one of the wokest television presenters there is. He pretends to be this big, strong alpha male, when we know fine well that he is left-leaning in the extreme. So what are we to do with the British media? Well, in the same way that we talk about draining the swamp in Westminster, draining the swamp at Stormont, we need to drain the swamp that supported the IRA, that acted as apologists for people like Shamima Begum, that acted as apologists for Islamist terrorists, that acted as apologists for communists, that acted as apologists for the Soviet Union. These people are still sniffing about in politics and in journalism. And to me, they are a huge part of the problem, and that swamp needs to be drained. How do we do it? Well, we encourage young, sensible people with sensible ideologies to get involved in journalism and take journalism by the horns and turn this ship round. Because I believe many newspapers, many media outlets, many editorial teams and the major broadcasters are completely infiltrated by the wokerati, by the far left, by the liberal elite. And it's time that that swamp was drained, as well as all the other swamps that need to be drained. See you all soon.